Joining me now with a reaction from Turning Point USA, Charlie Kirk, and Fox News contributor Tammy Bruce. All right, guys. I want to start with Mike Lee, and I'm going to start with you first, Tammy. I find it fascinating. I want to read the tea leaves here. The president says, quote, he's talking about Mike Lee, Senator Mike Lee. I actually saw him on television last night where he said he would love the job. You know, usually they don't say that, Mr. Trump said. Read the tea leaves, Tammy. What does that tell you?
Well, you'll recall Senator Lee was not very nice to the president during the campaign, but he's a good senator. He's well respected. His brother is also on the short list, who is also a judge. But the issue becomes, of course, one of the issues regarding if you remove someone from the Senate, we have such a short list,
yes.
Right? We have like one vote of ease. You don't want a special election where that could become a problem.
Right.
The general sense is that Mike Lee is not going to be chosen because of the problems associated with that. But you could make Senator Lee happy by choosing his brother, I suppose. And as a woman, as an advocate for women, it would be really fabulous to have a conservative woman
All
on
right.
the bench.
We'll talk
point
about
as well.
That. But Charlie, you know, the Mike Lee thing kind of surprised me. It's almost as though he's kind of pitching himself there. And you don't do that with the president. Yes.
Yeah, somewhat. You know, I'm a big Mike Lee fan. In fact, I think he's one of the more conservative people being put in this conversation that actually could get confirmed.
But what do you think about the fact that he's
Charlie,
what do you think about the fact he's never been a judge?
Well, look, I mean, he probably understands the Constitution better than every single left-wing person on the court right now. So I would say that. I mean, he's a student of history. He comes from his father was a very high-ranking judge. His brother's on the short list. He understands the Constitution. He understands the rule of law. And look, in the Constitution, it does not say you have to be a judge. It doesn't have to say that you've ruled on cases. It doesn't even say there has to be nine justices. So there is an argument to be made that if you pick someone out of the body of the Senate, it'll be very difficult for senators to vote against that individual. He could also vote for himself, which would be kind of unusual.
Yeah.
But look, he loves the Constitution. He understands federalism.
He loves
and he's
the
very young
but
versus
the
other
last
names.
Time yes. someone was nominated to the United States Supreme Court who was not a judge, even a lower court judge, was, I think, a half century ago. It just doesn't happen. So the whole thing is
sure, well, we could put
very
you judge.
Interesting. But there are so many. I'm sorry? Well, I didn't hear what you said, Charlie.
No, I said we could put you on the Supreme Court judge. I think that would be a great pick as well. Strong,
that's
conservative,
not what I'm looking for. I'm talking about someone who's never been a judge. And I think that's unusual. But let's talk about the women.
Yeah.
Tammy, you want to talk about the women. Now, Amy Coney, what is the last
Barrett.
Name? Yes, Barrett. Okay. Senator Dianne Feinstein gave her a very hard
That's
time
right.
about her Christianity, Catholicism.
This was just last year, so everyone will remember that horrible exchange where she was asking her, grilling her about her faith, which is not what you do. You can't make these decisions based on someone's religious convictions. And Ms. Barrett handled it very well. She was confirmed ultimately for the position she's in
Seventh
now.
Seventh Circuit.
Yes,
right.
for now about a year. So she's already been through that process. We already know what the Senate would do and what they would talk about. So that's interesting. She clerked for Judge Scalia, as did one of the other women on the short list as well. So they both have that experience. I would suggest, though, with Mike Lee, that the problem with him is being in the Senate, he's articulated many different positions already on the issues, mm-hmm. some of which are controversial. Mm-hmm. That will not be helpful in that regard. It shouldn't matter, but it won't be helpful. But Ms. Barrett, she's already been through it. I think that gives her an edge that we already know what would happen in the Senate.
Yes. And Charlie, with respect to Judge Barrett, there are also a few Democrats who voted for her a year ago. So that makes a difference, too. But isn't it interesting, Charlie, that now the president is in a position of affecting the law precedent for a generation and changing the court. The Democrats are going bananas.
That's right. The Democrats are not. They're afraid that not that Trump is going to fail. They're afraid he's going to succeed. One out of eight of all circuit court judges in America have already been appointed and implemented by President Trump. He's on pace to replace over half of the federal judiciary. It's absolutely remarkable. And this would give a permanent 5-4 conservative constitutional majority on the high court. And you saw the implication of this last week. Public sector unions will never be the same. The free speech court decision coming out of California in regards to the abortion facilities. And so President Trump to have two high court picks in just the first 2 years, it's absolutely phenomenal and stunning. Gorsuch was a home run, and I'm confident he's going to make another great selection here.
And with respect to the issue of choice, everyone is talking about choice as though it's the only issue that's at stake here.
Well, if I could add in that is the, when I was on the left, it was the only issue with which you could raise money. It is also an issue that they like to portray as existentially threatening. But the bottom line is, after all these years, it is never, with all the appointments and the Republican presidents and conservative judges appointed, it has never been an issue. It is precedent that is set. And this, I think, really is just one more element of the hysteria that the left is moving. The bottom line is, Americans like what the president is doing. They like Judge Gorsuch. We know something's gone wrong with this country, with the attitude that is perpetrated by liberals in the left, and we want reasonable, constitutionally based decisions. We know that improves everyone's lives,
right.
And there's already a war on some of these judges, and the president just has to stay the course.
Charlie, what does the president do to get Democrats to come around if, of course, McCain's not is not going to be voting, and we've got Collins and Murkowski? Possibly just
sure. So
for pro-life.
Yeah, I think he has
pro-life.
I think he has a better chance of getting Manchin and Donnelly than even Flake or Collins. I think a lot of these red state Democrats are going to have no choice but to come over and to vote for this pick, especially as we get up against the midterms here. It's going to be very difficult for some of these incumbent Democrats to go back to states where Trump won by 30 or 40 points and justify resisting a common sense constitutional selection to the Supreme Court. But President Trump has to do what he did tonight, go straight to these states and advocate for this pick, for this selection, and make the argument straight to the people.
All right, Charlie Kirk, Tammy Bruce, thanks so much for being with us tonight.